Hi everyone, it's Margaret, and today I am starting the series of video characters, and also I'm going to be doing some characters from like anime and some movie characters. So really stay tuned if you're into this. I've been getting so many requests. This is something that I'm not familiar with, I have to admit, because I don't really play a lot of video games or anything like that, but I do try my best to do some research, and a lot of people have asked me to do these characters, so this is my take on it. And like I said, many of these characters are anime or video game characters, so I'm doing like a live version of what I see in their image, and so I hope you like it. Anyway, I'm going to be doing Princess Zelda, and she's actually a Japanese character from a Nintendo video game. I believe it's her Japanese name is called Zelda Hime, which is meaning, Princess Zelda in English or in Japanese. So anyway, the game, I guess, is called Legend of Zelda. So anyway, I really studied her look, and I'm going to explain what I'm doing. So she's very, very kind of milky skin, almost kind of like she's got a warmth to it, but at the same time it's very milky at the same time. So and it's the coverage is very obviously intense because it's a animation character. So I'm gonna really give a nice coverage on the skin, and for those of you who are going to be doing, like a cosplay of this, definitely make sure that you use a good matte foundation and really set it very well. So I'm setting it with my wet sponge with some translucent powder after I put the foundation on, and I also concealed it and just really made sure everything's even. So I'm taking a pearl metallic shimmer type highlighting powder, and I'm going right underneath her brow bone and right in the inner part of her lid, as you can see. And this is what I'm doing just to kind of create some nice shading and gradation, and I think it adds more drama to the eyes. And I'm using a rounded brush just to make sure it gets a nice coverage in the inner, and then make sure that you get underneath the brow area well, so that it really gives that nice pop on the brow bone area. So I'm going to put some fallout powder here, and then on the lid I'm putting like a metallic copper color. And in the video character, she has kind of like a warmth to it, so I'm adding my little spin on it if I were to make her a live action character. So that's why I chose to use the copper, just to pop it out a little bit, because she is a princess and you want to definitely add some vibrancy, but at the same time her look is still very subtle, and so this is still keeps it neutral enough where it doesn't overshadow her look. But I think this is kind of a cool version of it in my opinion, because it gives it a little bit more, just a little bit more of a character to it. So as you see, I'm taking that copper shadow, and I'm using a really like shimmer luminescent metallic shadow powder, and really just coating it. And as you can see, I'm using a flat based brush, and that really helps add the color on. Now try to avoid using a really bulky fluffy head, because that's gonna just diminish the color and the payout. So always use a flat brush when you want to really add some depth to the color and really add more payout to the color. So see, that's the color that I used. It's very, very coppery. And so now I'm just gonna go over it again just to give it a little bit more coverage, and just to make sure it's all nicely set with that intensity. And I'm just going to add a little bit more accent on the outer and inner part of her crease, and just pulling it out ever so lightly. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go right on her inner crease, and I'm just going to add a little bit of gold. And this gold actually will, over that other color, it's a lamé color, as you can see. It's just going to add that more of that intensity, that really kind of gradation between the copper and the gold, it's going to really add a nice, I think, definition to the eyes, and yet it's going to create a nice glow to it. So I use that little blender brush to kind of merge it all together. So I'm using this like dark brown, metallic brown powder, and I'm just going to line the lash line with it. And what this does is it just will give it a nice rimming of the eyes, and at the same time, it's going to allow the eyes to really give it a nice definition, without taking away from all that gold and copper. I think it really just will actually accentuate the gold and copper. And just go right along the lash line and see, I'm using a flat tip pow I'm sorry, a flat tip brush, a very thin one, and I'm just going right along the ledge. So now I'm taking my powder brush and I'm just going to just dust off that extra fallout powder I added and just really make sure the whole face is nicely cleaned and not have too much of the powder sitting around her face. You just want to make sure everything looks really matte and smooth. So I'm going to take a highlighting powder, if you can see this. And this is called Luminescent. It's just a really just kind of a shimmer highlight powder. I'm just going to go along the top of her cheekbone and along the temple. And now I'm using this kind of bronzed contour color. And I'm going to go right along the ledge of her cheekbone. And see, I'm making her sucker cheeks in a little bit so that it gives it a nice definition. And you want to give it a nice warmth, but I'm still keeping it kind of metallic-y so it kind of merges with the same colors of the eyes. And just warm up the skin just ever so lightly. And see how it's just creating a nice summery kind of sunny look. Okay, so now I'm going to take this other shimmer and go right on the ledge again just to kind of like merge it with the two highlighting powders. And then just go all over her face with it just to kind of give it a nice glow. And this gives it a nice kind of like just a little bit of a shimmer glow without making it overly shimmer. And yet it kind of gives it a nice creamy texture to the skin. So if you can find like this, like a good shimmer creamy powder, that would be great. So I'm going to take that same color I used, that contouring shimmer color on the cheekbone, and I'm using a blending brush, and I just kind of went in the over the eyes with it, and see how it just kind of blends it all together. So now I took that dark brown powder and I'm just going right into the brows, and I'm defining the brows pretty strong, you know, because I think in the video character, her eyebrows have a distinct intensity to it. And here's the brush that I'm using. It's a flat tip, and then I'm going to use a mascara. I'm sorry, a mustache brush to just kind of blend it all together. And this definitely gives it a nice blending in. And I'm going to use a good coat of black mascara, and this will definitely help with adding more payout value if using a really super dark mascara. Now, if you like my techniques and you want to definitely learn some more professional level techniques, you could take my online training or come in for a one-on-one private training, or you could do a blended training. And my website is www.mkcbeautyacademy.com. And so, but definitely subscribe and stay tuned for a lot more, because I'm going to be doing a bunch of characters for the cosplay people and also for the people who want to do more certain characters. So I'll try to create a playlist for you guys. So here's for the lips. I'm using just a very kind of creamy, shimmery nude color, but it does have some intensity to it. It's not like just nude nude. It has a little bit more of a creaminess. And I saw that in her pictures, she kind of goes from really kind of darker lips to lighter lips. So I kind of went with this because I think it's really pretty, and it's and I want you girls to really wear this too and feel good about it. And there we go. So this is my version, live action version of Princess Zelda in the Nintendo series of Legend of Zelda. So I hope you like it. Please stay tuned for more, subscribe, and let me know what you think. Thanks so much. Bye.